Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and I want to talk about the power of shortcuts in Microsoft Fabric. And you may be like, well, like, what are we talking about with a shortcut? And enough of all this talking, you know what we like to do here on Guy in the Cube? Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So I'm gonna break this down into something really simple, and we're just looking at my desktop on my Windows machine. And there's this concept of file shortcuts in Windows, and you'll see here, I've got a shortcut here to my AdventureWorks Excel. This is just an object on my desktop. It's not the actual file. It's just a pointer to the file. So if I double click on this, this will open up the Excel document that's in whatever location that that shortcut is pointing to. You with me so far, right? That's a shortcut. It's just a reference. It's a pointer. Within Fabric, it's the same way that the shortcut is an object inside of OneLake within Microsoft Fabric that is just a reference to another location. The cool thing is this location can be something within inside of OneLake or within inside of Microsoft Fabric. It could be Lake House, it could be a warehouse, a KQL database. So this is for the real-time analytics pieces. And then we can also reference things that are outside of Microsoft Fabric. As an organization, you may already have data that's sitting out there in like an Azure Data Lake storage account inside of an Azure data center somewhere, so you know, within your Azure subscription. It could also be sitting out there in like an Amazon S3 bucket, and you don't necessarily want to move all that data or copy all that data. You want to leave the data where it is. And this is where the shortcut comes into play. And the idea concept behind OneLake is one copy of the data. I can load it somewhere once and then reference it and not have to recopy it everywhere that I want to go use this when we think about different workspaces inside of Microsoft Fabric. So we've got a lake house here that I've already put together. This is with like some taxi data. Patrick and I have been using this a lot lately. And a couple things you're going to see here. One is I've already got some defined tables in my lake house, and you'll see I've got like some dimension data. These are CSV files that are sitting inside of the file. So this is in OneLake, inside of Fabric, and sitting within this lake house. The other thing you'll see is this New York taxi, and you'll see it looks like a little link icon there. This is a shortcut, and specifically to an Azure Data Lake storage account that's somewhere out in Azure. It's not part of Microsoft Fabric. It's not even related to my Azure subscription at all. This is something else. I got access to this storage account somewhere else in Azure, and I'm referencing this from Microsoft Fabric. So you can see here, these are Parquet files that are sitting in this Azure Data Lake storage account. This could be Amazon S3. I don't care. It's just out there and it's represented with inside of OneLake and with inside of this lake house. So now I can leverage it. And then this fact cab rides table, this is actually leveraging the Parquet files from this New York taxi Azure Data Lake storage account. So when I'm actually loading up this preview, it's pulling that data from that Azure Data Lake storage account, which is bananas. And so this is represented in this table. I can access it through a SQL endpoint. I can reference this from a PySpark perspective. And so this is ready for me. And this is just coming off of some Azure Data Lake storage account, which is great. I didn't have to copy any of that data. And that's the key. It's just one copy of the data. This is sitting out in an Azure Data Lake storage account. An end perspective would be a Power BI report sitting on top of this, which is amazing. So this is cool. How did I actually do this? I went to get data. This is one way. You can come to new shortcut. Or in this case, when I was creating the reference from the New York taxi, I just right-clicked on files and said new shortcut. So if I go to get data and then new shortcut, you'll see that you're given some options. So I can say Microsoft OneLake. I can also say the Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2 or the Amazon S3. And if I come into Microsoft OneLake, you'll see here, these are where my lake houses, warehouses, and KQL database can sit, and I can reference those, or I can come back in and I can say, hey, where's my storage account? So I can go forth and enter the connection details for that storage account and tell it how I want to authenticate against that data and then leverage the data from that perspective. But Adam, this is just one lake house, right? I need to create another lake house, or I need to create a warehouse. Like, what am I doing from a warehouse perspective? You cannot create a shortcut from a warehouse, but you can reference it from a T-SQL perspective on the lakehouse side of it. You can actually create the shortcut to this external data, and then you can leverage that data in a warehouse, but you've got to do this from a lakehouse or a KQL database. So let's go to another lakehouse that I have, and you'll see here that I've got nothing here. There's no tables, no files. And so what I'm going to do here is get data, new shortcut, and I want to leverage the data that I already had in that other lakehouse. Lakehouse. And so this is in a different workspace, by the way. So I'm going to go to next, and then I'll see the tables and the files that are available. And so here I can actually reference that shortcut that was made in the other Lakehouse, which is amazing. And so if I just say, look, I want to take advantage of that, I'm going to reference that data here, assuming you have all the right permissions and all of this is in place, especially even between different workspaces. Obviously, not everyone can just go and do this. So one of the challenges you'll see here is it's trying to identify it as a table, but it can't do that in this scenario. So you would have to do some PySpark stuff to get this up and running successfully. Let's just go ahead and delete this. And then we can come back in and I could say new shortcut, Lakehouse, and then taxi data. I could come in and pull in the table instead. This is based off of those files, right? And then I can say create. And now that will be listed there as well. And then bam, I'm looking at this data that's coming from a shortcut that's defined in another workspace and it's working. And so that's the table that I referenced. Let's reference the files. Let's go into files. We'll do new shortcut, OneLake, taxi data, files, pull in that shortcut as well. And now I have a shortcut referencing a shortcut, which is bananas, right? And it's working. I didn't copy any data. This data is actually in that other Azure Data Lake storage account. It's not even in OneLake at this point. But if you do have it in OneLake, that's the idea, is I can reference that from other lakehouses and or Cakewell databases and reuse that data. Then I can pull that in from a warehouse perspective and or I can pull that from a Power BI dataset perspective. And then we're reusing that piece of it. As we go forward with Microsoft Fabric, I'm expecting that there will be new options as part of shortcuts and enhancements on this front. So definitely stay tuned to GuyInACube for more updates on that front, and also the Fabric blog to stay up to date with all the announcements and releases. I'm excited for what shortcuts will do, because the power here is just amazing with one copy of the data and not having to move that data, which is key for a lot of organizations, especially if you've already got your data in a certain spot. You want to just leverage it where it's at and not have to copy that into yet another place. And so as you create new things, maybe that will land in a OneLake, and over time those things will surface inside of OneLake directly. But if you've already got it in that other location, just use it. All right, let me know in the comments what you think. Are you leveraging this? Did this blow your mind? Were you aware of it? I'd love to know. And if you're just starting your Microsoft Fabric journey, check out this playlist that's sitting above my head so you can learn more and get started with all the new things. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.